Hello, you're on Pablo's Spot, I'm George. On this episode, I will show you how I use Terraform to configure temporary AWS credentials in Vault. So, let's start coding. In AWS, there are a number of things that we all need to keep in mind in order to ensure that we keep our AWS accounts safe from intrusion. And the most fundamental of these include number one, avoiding root accounts from being used regularly. And then secondly is using a separate account for infrastructure management, which generally means you don't use your root account in creating, updating, and deleting infrastructure resources using Terraform. In my previous episodes, I have been showing you a separate step to export an AWS profile before running Terraform commands. This approach actually comes with a risk. This means I have an AWS access key and secrets stored locally, and this access key and secret never expire. And if for some reasons these access keys get compromised and get leaked, and then someone else get access to this information, they can get access to my AWS account as well, and they can do all sorts of things. What I need is to stop using AWS credentials that are not expiring, and this is what I will show you today. This video assumes that we already have a Vault system that we can use and connect to. I have set up a very simple local infrastructure for Vault that leverages on the Vault's Docker image. So let's verify if we can log into to my Vault. So if we open our browser, my Vault endpoint is actually on port 32648. So let's go and access that endpoint. Now if I log into Vault using my own token, I should get a bare minimum fresh install of a Vault system. So back to my VS Code. To start writing the code, I'll start creating a new directory. Then I'll start writing my first Terraform configuration. So I'll create a file here called provider.tf. And then my Vault provider block will look like this. I have stored my Vault token in AWS Systems Manager, so I'll add a provider block for AWS. And then I'll create a data.tf to put the reference to my Vault token. Save my changes to data.tf, and then go back to my provider.tf. So in here, I'll pull out the data reference to the Vault token and plug it into the token property inside my Vault provider. Save my changes. And then because I've introduced two new variables in here, I need to start creating my variables.tf. Save my changes to the variables.tf. The next thing that I need to set up with Vault is a mechanism to generate the temporary AWS credentials. The first thing I do is create my main.tf and then set up the Vault backend resource to enable the integration. For the access key and secret key, I've stored the values in my parameter store in Systems Manager in AWS. So I'll define data references for these values and then plug them in into this resource. So let's jump into the data.tf. So now that I've set up the data references to my AWS access key and secret, I'll go back to the main.tf and then update the values for my access key and secret key properties. Now, I need an AWS IAM role that will be assumed when generating my temporary AWS access keys and secrets. So I'll create a AWS IAM role resource in my main.tf. So to define the assume role policy property of my role, I'll create a data reference to an IAM policy document. So let's go to our data.tf. And then to pull my current AWS account without hard coding the account ID, I'll add a data reference to the caller identity resource. So now all I have to do is update this current account to have reference to this caller identity. Let's update the IAM role resource to reference this policy document. Now I need to attach a policy to this role. For example, I want to add the administrator access policy. So I'll create a policy attachment resource. For the policy ARN, I need to pull out a data reference to the administrator access policy. So let's go to data.tf and add that. Save changes to data.tf, and now I'll update my role policy attachment to have a reference to this policy. And then we also added tags in my IAM role, so I'll go ahead and create the locals.tf file. Next, I need to set up a role resource in Vault to generate temporary AWS credentials. So let's go back to our main.tf. And then in here, I'll create a Vault AWS secret backend role. This backend property here actually references the Vault AWS secret backend that we've created at the earlier part of the main.tf. So if I scroll up, it's actually a reference to this resource. So this role ARNs, I need to update to contain the ARN of the role that we've defined in here. Save all my changes, and then I'll create my input.tf vars. And then I also need to create a backend.tf. I'm going to be using Terraform Cloud. I'm actually naming my workspace as Vault Secrets. So that's my bare minimum infrastructure code. So let me go ahead and start running my Terraform commands. So first, I'll open my terminal and then export my AWS profile and then cd to Vault creds. And then now I start running my Terraform init. In the previous episode on Terraform Cloud, we talked about the default execution mode for workspaces when using Terraform Cloud. So by default, when I run Terraform init, the workspace gets created automatically, but it has an execution mode of remote. For me to be able to control running Terraform commands locally, I need to change that from remote to local. So let's go and access Terraform Cloud. Let's open our browser. And then in here, go to Terraform Cloud. If you notice, the Vault Secrets workspace got created a minute ago. So let's open that. Go to Settings, General, and then scroll down to Execution Mode, and then change that to Local. Save settings. Now if I go back to my code, I should now be able to run Terraform Plan and Terraform Apply. So having run the Terraform commands successfully, let me go back to my browser and quickly verify that the new AWS Secret Engines has been set up. So in Vault, if I refresh this page, log back in, and then you should see this AWS Secret Engine that got created. So let's try to generate temporary token from the user interface. So if you click that, and then that's the role, and in here, we click generate credentials. Change the credential type to assumed role. Generate. This has successfully given me a secret key and secret token. So now that we have verified that the AWS secret engine has been set up in Vault successfully, let me show you how I can start using this in my infrastructure as code in Terraform. So what I will do is copy the infrastructure code from the previous episode and use this to check if the integration works. So let me go back to my code. And then cd one directory up. And then I need to copy the infrastructure directory from episode 12. So let's just expand that and delete the ones that we don't need. Now what I need to do is update my providers.tf and set the proper references to my Vault credentials. So let's open providers.tf. And then in here, I will add a new provider block for my Vault. I've added a new variable in here, so I need to update my variables.tf. Save my changes. And then I need to update my AWS provider to reference the temporary AWS credentials. So let's go back to providers.tf. So the values from these three new fields in the provider AWS block will need to be obtained from a data reference to a Vault AWS credentials. So let's go to data.tf and create a data block for the Vault AWS access credentials. Make sure that the type is provided in here and then the value is set to STS. So now let's go back to the provider.tf and update the AWS provider block. So before I start running my Terraform commands, I need to clear the AWS profile environment variable from my local session. So let's do that. Now, to verify that I have completely cleared my session from any AWS credentials on my local machine, I'll run a simple S3 LS. It failed because there's no credential set up. Now, instead of exporting an AWS profile, I need to export a Vault environment variable called Vault_token. So now that that's set, let's clear this session. And then I'm gonna start running my Terraform commands. So let's cd to infrastructure, run Terraform init. So before we start running plan as well as apply, let's just verify that the Lambda function that this infrastructure creates does not exist in my AWS account. So let's open my browser and then go to Lambda. And then I also need to make sure that I'm on the right region, which is in US East 1. And then as you can see, there are no Lambda functions in my AWS account. So let's go back to my code and then start running my Terraform commands. So our Terraform plan failed. It says here, a data resource access key has not been declared in the root module. So I think we're missing the arbitrary name of the resource. So on line 7, it should be data vault AWS access credentials.aws. And it's the same thing for the other two. Save all changes. Let's rerun the Terraform plan. And then now let's start running Terraform apply. So the plan and apply was successful. So let's go and check if the infrastructure resources have been created in my AWS web console. Let's refresh this page. There's the Lambda function that's created. That's all I have for today. As usual, let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Send me some likes and share this video if you think someone might find it useful. And if you could, subscribe and help me spread the word about this channel. Until next time, see ya.